Standing right over there, please welcome my good friend, Ms. April Walterscheid.
A little do-si-do, thanks, Rob. Hi guys, I'm April. How's it going? Anybody get any Black Friday deals?
Say yeah! Woo!
What was it?
Headphones.
Headphones, are they cheap?
Yeah.
Hello Kitty ones, right?
Yep.
Yeah! There's a store I went to today, and their little deal was, you know, if you buy $100, you get a free receipt, gift receipt, so that's a good deal. Good job, I love it. My name's April. I'm single, I live alone, I'm really proud of that. Is anyone else proud of being single, living alone? Yeah! One person, I don't even see them, they're so ashamed, okay. Anyways. I live alone, and I live in a duplex. I live next to somebody, a couple actually, you know. They had a baby recently or something. I don't hear her crying. I thought I would. I saw her pregnant one day. I'm like, oh shit, that thing's going to be born one day and living next to me? I better move. But no, it's fine. I didn't hear the baby. I think it doesn't live there. I don't know. I think I would hear it. But anyways, I recently found my Sonicare toothbrush. I've been using just a regular toothbrush for the past year. My teeth don't feel so great. But I'm afraid to use it because our bathrooms are next to each other. One thin wall divides the bathrooms. They're a little off kilter a little bit, but I'm afraid to use the Sonicare, so I finally put some batteries in it. I ran it, you know, and I was like, oh, this is the best brush of my life. It's the best brush of my life. And I was like, oh, wait. They think I'm getting it on with my vibrator. So, they're probably like over there like, that poor girl, that single girl who lives alone, who's probably lived there for years, she apparently thinks vibrators are called toothbrushes. Oh, that poor thing, she's so isolated from people. She doesn't have any friends that she thinks a toothbrush is a vibrator. Bless her heart. They have moved though, I think they got scared, so that's good. I can vibrate all I want in my mouth. So, that's really cool. Is anyone familiar with that ISIS thing, you know, Islamic State? I found out they have a publication, anyone know that? They have like a magazine.
Yeah.
It's very well, it's written in like 500 languages because they're trying to convert everybody, you know. It's written in Martian as well. They're hoping for extraterrestrial life to like fly down and join. So they have a publication, and it's really cool. Actually, it's not, but it's cool that they are like well-educated more than I thought. They basically are trying to get people to come over. You know, Syria's leaving. All the Syrians are leaving. And like, wait, come back. It's not that bad. Explosions aren't so bad. Come back. You know, death is all right. But they're trying to get everyone back, so they're offering like a lot of benefits, like kind of like PayPal or eBay or Intel would offer, you know? Like, come back, we have a gym. Come back, we have whatever that other companies have. Come back so they help us out. So I was considering it. I was like, if I go over there, you know, I'm probably gonna get banged and have kids or something. So I wanna ask them if they have daycare. Do you guys have daycare, 401k, secret stock trade options that you might be under a different code, but like there's still stock options, the employee stock plan. So I wrote an email, I'm waiting for a response. I think their interpreter is gonna write back. Cause he writes all the articles, so. He converts them, I guess. Converts him. Speaking of ISIS, my dad, growing up, he was kind of Hitler. He's a science guy. He would go to my school and like show us how to make barometers out of balloons in a jar. Anyone know that thing? Anyone an engineer? Anyone a Nazi engineer? Raise your hand. No. Oh, kind of. Okay. So he's into weather and all that stuff. That's a side project, is like tornado chasing through the news, you know. He's
so
storm chasing his mind.
Um,
So he would do all that kind of stuff. He would put like a Tesla electricity unit on our roof for Halloween. It just has like a electricity current going up and down, you know, to scare the kids away. We never got any trick-or-treaters. We thought our house was gonna electrocute them as soon as they touched the doorbell. So my dad does all this science stuff, right? But he's still religious, and I don't get that. He still believes in God. What's that about? I thought he was like an up-and-coming atheist. It'd be really cool. But growing up was kind of tough because my dad and mom, you know, were so strict. I had chores, guys, and I got paid for them. It sucks. Hey guys, awesome. Sorry. So I had chores, and you know, I couldn't have any friends. So I finally got my first job, and then I got fired from it. And my mom's like, "Oh my God, we need to have a talk." So they called a family meeting, as they always do when something's pissing them off, like me pissing them off all the time. So they're like, "We need to have a family meeting," and my mom's like, "I can't believe you lost your job. You're a fuck up, my fuck up daughter." So I'm like, "Oh, cool, all right." And then just like maybe 2 years ago, my mom lost her job. And I'm like, "Mom, what happened?" She's like, my year-end review was, oh, and I'm like, "Mom.
Love you long time."
I had a fuck up, Mom. That's it, guys. Thank you.
That's April Waldershine, you guys.